We were talking about the issue about, you know, training.
Yeah.
I'm doing some MMA and some BJJ and
okay.
the issue of hitting in the face. We were debating with the brothers earlier because that came up issue with the issue about Khabib. It always comes up.
Yeah, yeah.
You know, you're praising him. Oh, hitting the face, it's haram. Okay, Islamically, yes, it is haram. But what is the level? And it was something interesting. There was a podcast recently with Brother Muhammad Hijab and Faris Zahabi, which is he's the trainer of George St. Pierre. And
the George St. Pierre.
So he's a Muslim brother, Faris Zahabi, by the way. Mashallah.
Don't know who that is.
Come on, if you don't know, you have like.
I must admit that my knowledge of MMA background.
If you know,
my knowledge of MMA isn't what
he's one of the greatest. And actually, by the way, I like him. I like George St. Pierre because, he does have some, you know. Some humbleness. He doesn't. He's a very nice guy, and even if you look like
you can tell some people have noble character traits.
Yeah, Daniel Cormier, for example, one of the we're talking about non-Muslim fighters, but people have akhlaq, they have manners. Yeah. Even Dustin Poirier, the one who fought Khabib last time, and I did actually talk about him, and then I had a problem uploading from I didn't upload my YouTube channel, but it is on my Facebook. Some of the benefits we gained from the fight there, the post fight. And from that was, you know, the respect that Khabib showed, the good things that.
So you're basically like a part-time MMA commentator, aren't you?
Well, maybe.
Benefits of every fight.
Alhamdulillah. Interesting in this podcast.
That's a good niche, I think you found.
Maybe. I'm thinking about now. Because back to what I was saying, in Bollywood, where they told me one time, the guy said, "You're excellent behind the camera. You're a natural." I said, "Well, maybe I chose the wrong field to be in because I'm broke being a daddy, man. I got no money. So look, I'd be a rich Bollywood guy, you know. I'd have to be a little dude, you know, point all the time
dancing
and
all
dancing. But at the end, have some money. Astaghfirullah, alhamdulillah. The
films are like 3 hours, man. It's not worth it.
So, alhamdulillah.
I'd go Hollywood if I were you.
Just feel like,
you're done Hollywood in 90 minutes.
Today. At least the voice, yeah. Maybe inshallah I could go.
Yeah.
Astaghfirullah. May Allah protect us. Sometimes you have that stuff, it opens up for you, and then you fall into the fitna, you fall into the haram.
Yeah.
And may Allah help us.
So you're talking about punching in the face?
Punching in the face, yeah. So
these brothers criticize you and you punch them in the face?
On the podcast, that we talked about in the lecture last night about, you know, controlling oneself. The guy was looking at me at the airport, especially when you start to know martial arts. But the beautiful thing about martial arts, the more you know, the more more you understand about martial arts, the more you know about defeating your opponent, the more confidence you get, actually, the less you want to fight. It's always the one who doesn't know how to fight who wants to fight.
And they
come with the haymakers, and they come with this. And you just sit back and get in your stance, maintain the distance, and
that scares them.
And then he wears out. And then, bismillah, you go and you take him down. You know, it's very easy because he doesn't know how to fight.
We do not condone violence. Yeah. Sound truly.
Bismillah. And the thing, that could be my next article, by the way.
Yeah.
Bismillah, or my first article.
How to take someone out.
That's it, take one down. Yeah. So you start to learn that you can do it. And the confidence that you can do it.
We believe in love and peace.
That's it, love and peace. Huh? So the confidence that you can do it actually helps you not to do it.
Stay out of the fight.
Because you know I could smash this guy.
Yeah.
You
don't feel you have something to prove.
That's it. So it's always the ones who have something to prove. But I mean, if someone attacks you, then you have to defend yourself. We mentioned the lecture last night about the guy in the airport. He was staring at me, you know. And I said, like, I come from a jahiliya background, you know. Where we're from, you stare at someone, people would get shot where I lived, you know. Or where I used to hang out anyways when I was a non-Muslim.
Where was that?
It's in the D.C. area, Washington, D.C. area. I'm from the Virginia side of the border, but D.C. is, like, right next to us. So people would get shot for looking at people there, you know. They used to call it gritting on them. That was our term back in the day. If someone grits on you, looks at you like this, that's war right there. So this guy's looking at me in the airport like this, and I'm like, this guy, man, you know. And he kept doing it, you know. So it's like really testing me. But then I remember the teaching.
They were like, "AbdurRaheem, is that you?"
No, yes, sir. And knock him out. Like, sorry, bro. I didn't know. Alhamdulillah. No, this guy was a non-Muslim. You could see, and he was just looking at me. Yeah. And then you have that thing like he looking at you as a Muslim, looking at your wife as a hijabi. And you have to control yourself. But what is the teachings? What is the teaching of our beloved Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam? He said, "Laysa shadidu bisurati." He said, "The one who is strong is not the one who can wrestle people down." وَإِنَّمَا الشَّدِيدُ الَّذِي يَمْلِكُ نَفْسُهُ عِنْدَ الْغَضَبِ. That the one who's the strong one is the one who controls himself at the time of anger. And that's one of the things that martial arts teaches you as well. You know you can beat someone down, so you have nothing to prove in coming to try to do it. So then, alhamdulillah, but when it comes back to hitting the face, back to the podcast, we're getting a bit off track.
So you punched him?
No, alhamdulillah, I control myself. I followed the sunnah, alhamdulillah, and just looked away. Yeah. And then just walked away, alhamdulillah. And
that's my story, I'm sticking to it.
Alhamdulillah, that's it. So when I walked around, actually an interesting story I have on my YouTube channel about the Muslim scholar who knocked out three racist thugs. Go back and listen to it. It's very beautiful. You know the Sheikh too.
Was it on the train?
Yeah, on the train. You might know
the
story.
I think I've heard this.
The funny thing was that the Sheikh called me And he said, I'm preparing my bag to travel. I'm listening to the story someone sent me on WhatsApp. And it's you telling the story about him knocking the people out. 3-on-1, Michelle. He was trained, yeah. So he knew how to defend himself and defend his family. So if you need it, you use it, obviously. In the gym we train in Ireland, our coach, he taught us, and he teaches my son who trains with him, and I train with him in private lessons as well. He teaches the kids. He said these other schools, you know, about, you know, certain, you know, not, I don't want to, you know, talk about any negative about any martial arts, but certain martial arts, they say don't only use it in the gym, don't never use it in the street. Yeah. He said because it doesn't work. They don't want to be exposed that it doesn't work. But he said we want our kids, if they're bullied, if they're this, to protect themselves, to use what they've learned in the gym. We had one kid. He was a Polish kid who trained with my son. I know he had some, you know, with his glasses, maybe a bit, you know, he was a cute-looking boy, maybe someone he would pick on him by the way he looked, you know. Mm-hmm. He looked a bit mesquine how he would handle himself, but he was training with them as well. So this big bully was always, you know, picking on him for over a year. And after 1 year of training, MMA and BJJ, he grabbed the kid, did a hip toss, put him on the ground, made the bully cry. The bully kind of thought, you know, he got lucky. Came back 2 weeks later, tried his luck again, same throw, same put down, same result. So what happened, our coach came and he said, I want to applaud him. And he came and he rewarded him, bought him a gift, and applauded him in front of all of the other students. If you're bullied, then use it. But you don't, and that martial law teaches you not to be the transgressor. But if somebody comes to harm you.
I suppose it's better than, you know, the kid bottling it up and then becoming some mass shooter in life.
It could ruin him for the rest of his life, man. And that's what bullying does. That's a sad thing about bullying. Even some who have committed suicide, subhanAllah.
I think the controlled and mediated use of violence in a very controlled and measured way, I think it's natural.
That's one of the things we talk about learning martial arts for our kids. One of the good things about BJJ is that you can actually take someone down and you can control them until an adult comes.
Until they calm down,
or they decide they say they're gonna you know calm down. That kind of, and you could submit them if you need
to. So back to the original issue, if about punching in the face, somebody would say.
Okay, so on the podcast, Brother Faris, he said, I can accept. And he said, there's anyone out there from a mufti, I don't consider myself a mufti, I'm a student of knowledge, but I will give my 2 cents on what he said. Because he said, because we're not, you know, I'm not remembering exactly his phrases, but he was saying that, you know, if someone is actually, you know, it's they're not like at war, you know, it's a competition, trained martial artist.
It's an art, a sport,
but that they're also trying to see which one is superior. So this is one of the things they're trying to determine now. One of the benefits of going, you know, full combat is to determine which martial art is superior, which one is the best, and how it can evolve, and all these type of things. Which is very interesting what he said. However, we could say that with the first few UFCs, that's been proven, that the martial art that is superior is grappling in BJJ. Yeah. And even Bruce Lee, he mentioned that a person who trains in wrestling and boxing for 1 year, he could beat a lifetime martial artist. That's how really? That's how effective those arts are. And when it comes to the issue of hitting in the face, obviously the ruling stays the same, that it's not permissible in Islam. However, when it comes to sparring and things like that, as we were speaking with the brothers earlier, you kind of have to be in a live sparring situation to know what to do. When I would train with my coach in Ireland, he would come and you have to duck. You know how to move right, move left, move your head. If you don't move, what's going to happen? Bismillah. Yeah. He's coming.
Your own fault.
You're going to get hit. You didn't move. You knew what you were supposed to do and you didn't do it.
I mean, he was just doing that. Yeah, your face had to be there.
But obviously here, with this type of sparring, what are we doing? He's not coming full force down trying to knock me out or break my nose.
I mean, it's different than, you know, someone grabbing you and trying to beat the hell out of you.
And that's it. Yeah. So if it's that type of thing, I think where you're sparring with someone who's a sane sparrer, not the crazy one who's going all out, then I think there's nothing wrong with that, to do it sometimes. You don't want to do it too much because someone could get hurt. I mean, that's my opinion. Okay. I think it's a bit of a middle ground where you could, you know, when you're sparring, but as a sport and things like that, I think the ruling is going to remain the same where it is haram. However, if that's what someone chooses to do, we have to remember that there's different scenarios, different circumstances. People come from poor countries, they're finding a way out. Yeah. We're not in their shoes. And in the end, that's between them and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala.
And the Muslim community, we need to realize that there are some people, almost full of people who they have negative aspects, but there's a lot of good you can learn from.
We see a lot of the brothers who are professional athletes now. Yeah. They might do some things that are haram, but they have a lot of good as well. We have to applaud that.
And inshallah, Allah will wipe the good out, the harm, inshallah. Not the other way around.
I always try to look at things as positive, you know. And as we talked about last night, the mindset of the believer. Always try to look at things in a positive light. Always try to find where's the hikmah, where's the wisdom behind things, because there's always good in the affairs of the believer, as the Prophet ﷺ told us. Alhamdulillah.